for Eric not long after he died. And I don't want to, I'll just have a short preamble into the poem, because, I've been a friend of the Freak family since the 70s, and so I knew Eric throughout the 70s and 80s as well. And I was very often at the house, and I think it was a year or two before he died, and for some reason I was out there. I was at his house, and we left together to walk to the tube station. He was going to a poetry event in London, and usually it would take about maybe under 10 minutes, but with Eric it would take much longer, maybe over 20 minutes, because he wasn't so well, and he walked very slowly, but also he would always stop to pick something up off the ground and put it in a bag, which he had especially for the, it would be a buyer or an apple or anything. Anyway, near the end of, just a couple of doors down from his house, there was a ruined garden, and he just said to me, "Oh, there are wonderful blackberries in there." And so, after he died, I wrote this poem called "Stealing Blackberries" for Erich Fried. If a man is too old to climb over a fence, can he be too old to incite you to a crime? Pointing with his stick, here there hangs forbidden fruit. The woman of the house whose garden this was has been driven out by property developers. Her house and her garden are gone to ruin, and blackberries grow wild here all through the autumn. Go over the fence and get us some. Some at least shall not be wasted or left only for the birds. Forgive us our trespasses. I went over the fence with the glass jar he'd given me, a dark day in November, too late in the year for blackberries, and scarce seemed there any. But I got down to work, crouched in wet grass, reaching deep into the brambles, and took the best, the sweetest, the most hidden fruit. A police helicopter was circling up above. Birds stopped their chatter. My glass was all full. With hands streaked with blood and the juice of blackberries, I stole through the garden like the thief I was. Deliver us from evil. I dropped into the street. "What kept you so long?" said his voice in my ear. But turning towards him, I found no one there, and I knew he was gone. Couldn't wait any longer. Had to abandon me here with my stolen fruit in the valley of the shadows of a London street. A November evening, police sirens wailing. If a man is too old to climb over a fence, can he be too old to incite you to a crime? Thank you.